The Large Hadron Collider at CERN on the border between Switzerland and France is one of the most fascinating machines built by scientists to study fundamental questions of our universe. Can Julia language help with data analysis there? Well, let's discuss this. My name is Mikhail Mikasenko. I work as a research fellow at CERN with the LHCb experiment for the last 2 years and currently moving to the Origins cluster in Munich. Down 100 meters from the point on the surface where LHCb is shown here, you find the detector. That's a forward spectrometer measuring the particles produced in the collision of two protons. And most exciting and excited particles do not leave. They decay immediately, and only analyzing their decay products, we learn their properties. The Hadron spectroscopy goes down to the centimeter scale and study the properties of the matter. Atoms are made of the protons and neutrons, which also have internal structures. And in addition to the regular matter types, we have strong evidence for the existence of the exotic matter, tetraquarks, pentaquarks, you might have heard of them. Omega C baryon, which I studied recently, is the state similar to proton while containing two strange quark and one C quark. The excited spectrum of omega C might hint a mixture of the states with the exotic components. The first observations of the excited states was in 2017, and the new analysis just appeared on archive. We measure the spectrum where the peaks indicate excited omega C states. So the spectrum needs to be fitted by the model, extracting the positions, the widths, and the properties. And before going to the details, let me discuss the typical workflow in the HEP analysis. So the data collected by experiments over the last 10 years is a huge samples. The first steps reduce the data sample to several terabytes, which already can be handled by individuals. The fine selections on the third step involves usually multivariate analysis and neural networks. And the last step is really modeling, when you come up with a model and adjust the parameters of the model to fit the data, and in that way extract the physics information. The common framework used in HAP is ROOT. And I think in Julia ecosystem over years, we have more and more alternatives to those components. Let me show you Algebra PDF, the package which I created for the modeling process and fitting the data. In HAP, we like that parameters of the models are internal components of the model. So it means they have default values. You should be able to fix them and release in the fit. And in addition, the models could be rather complex, made of several components, as here you see that the model that describes the spectrum contains the two background shapes and the five signal shapes and the fractions of them, and the parameters of individual structures is adjusted in the fit. It's actually done in rather short script using Algebra PDF package, plotting packages of Julia and the data packages. And I start by loading the settings, which I keep in JSON file. So then here is how the raw data look like. There is clearly four narrow structures and one threshold structure. And every signal structure is described by the Breitwigner amplitude. That function has two parameters, mass, position of the peak, and the width, how broad the state is, to be adjusted in the fit. I create the instance of the function with parameters passing the lambda functions and the default values of the parameters. And once it's created, I can use it as a regular Julia function, calling number argument or broadcasting over the vector. And it returns complex. So I can also check the parameters of the functions, which are shown here. Next step is to get the density function out of this. And in order to do this, one needs to square the amplitude. Once it's squared, it can be plotted in the range of the fitting. And this is how the function looks like. It's not yet normalized. It's not PDF. Once we normalize, the integral becomes one. already this PDF can be tried, can be fitted to the data. And although we get some reasonable error bars to the value of the mass and width, the fit is not senseless with one component. Now we want to create the four instances of this PDF and assign different parameters to be adjusted in the fit. For that, I create a struct inherited from the abstract function with parameters, and then pass different parameters to the instances of this structure. For the structural structure, I use a little bit different function, and this is a short way to construct the function with parameters by passing this definition to the macro that creates a type omega c bright Wigner g, and then this type with the parameters creates an instance. The last component is the background needed for this fit. The model is a sum of all components with the coefficients to be adjusted in the fit. And I can plot the model to see that it indeed has a 6 components, 1 background and 5 peaks. And I created the recipe that we see separate components. Well, one more thing, I know from previous studies that the amount of the backgrounds account for 15 events out of this 200. That's why I will fix my parameter FB to 15. The model is ready, but it's not PDF since normalization is not one, rather the sum of the individual normalizations. And in order to fit this, I used extended log likelihood method that would enforce normalization of my function, fitting function, to be equal to the number of events. I perform the fit and check the measurements, the parameters with their error bars. Then we plot it and save the picture to PDF and the results to the JSON files. Well, the fit looks nice. The further improvement would require taking into account the experimental resolution that would widen a little bit the peaks. So the save JSON file can also highlight quickly it has the parameters with error bars and fixed parameters as well. To summarize, I think Julia is well suited for her problems, which are essentially mathematical computing on the large data sets and statistical modeling. I just highlighted you algebra PDF and the modeling of the spectrum, but in addition, there were Julia will use triangular analysis plotting, as well as I found very convenient to combine Julia with the DVC data version control tool and rerun the analysis accounting for systematic studies. I'm looking forward to seeing more Julia in HAP. Join us in Slack in our meetings, and I would like to mention two great talks given by Jan and Philip at PyHAP 2021. That's it, ciao.